to Sheep New 360. Most of the time, my sheep just like to walk around and eat.
Yes, that was a little movie from the Faroe Islands. And dear all, I'm very glad to be here together to you with colleagues who also, as me, are implementing the school volleyball from the CEV. My name is Peter Morell, and I'm a development director in Volleyball Denmark. For the past 3 years, I have also been working in the Faroe Island implementing a school volleyball. And my speech today is about the philosophy and the pedagogic that we use in the work with schools and clubs in these islands. The knowledge we used is based on many years' work in Danish Volleyball Federation with schools, small children, and with teachers and students. But I've shown a little video just to tell you the context that we are now talking into. As you could see on the movie, this is a beautiful nature up there. But it's not only a beautiful nature, there are also a lot of volleyball. The Faroe Islands, there are 18 islands, and it's far up north in North Atlantic. And we are only 50,000 inhabitants up there. So actually, I think we are the smallest country here. But we have there's a great passion for sport, and the national sport is actually rowing in special ferry boats. But volleyball is number 3 sport up there. But I think you all can guess what sport number 1 is. Yeah, that's football. Correct. The volleyball on the Faroe Islands are quite new, and it was founded in 1980. So, and it started with Russian fishermen coming in with their boats to the harbors, and they put up nets, and they would start playing volleyball and inviting locals to join in. And that's how it all was starting up there. And it has grown indeed. So now there are a lot of people playing volleyball up there. There are 9 clubs up there, and they all have kids volleyball for youth and also senior volleyball. And they are playing in cup competition and everything. So actually, they are doing very well in the Faroe Islands. But that was enough about the island, so let's see. Let me start my presentation by asking, is it necessary to have a project about school volleyball? Why should we have it? And how does it make sense for clubs? And how does it make sense for teachers? So my presentation is more about what can we benefit of being in that project as a club and as a teacher. When we make an intervention in the schools, there are some things that must be in place. There's been some questions from the audience about how many children are we actually at the school? We need to know how is the school system function where we are going to do the intervention. We need to know the curriculum teaching methods and principles. Because don't we know that it don't make any sense, it don't make any sense to go into a school if we don't know that. For example, we have to know when we go to a school, how many hours do they have a gym? Do they have a small gym? Do they have a big hall? So it's very important that we recognize that and look at that as a club. So it is very important to do that. When we go into schools, we can look at it as in a club perspective. And how can we be a success in the schools? I think that we have to present something new and motivational for the children and teachers. And as Christoph and Remco told, they have some bit on that is two against two, one against one. And as Remco said, he knows that was the key to success. Maybe we have more keys to success because I represent some other games we have very big success with in Denmark that could be key to success. But it is very important that when we come into the schools, we have to have a game that could be set quick into motion. It's very, very important. And not using too many materials. I know when I come to a school and I see teachers, they have to put up four nets and they have to do a lot of things before they can do a normal school lesson in 2 hours. They prefer something to put in a ball and then they can play football. So it is very important that we can do it easy. So also as Remco tell, we always use a band from one end to another end of the sports hall and then they just can play. So for us it's very necessary that it's easy for the teachers. So as a club, do it easy when you come into a school, do it simple, then you can have success in the schools. Our answer to that is that it's kids volley actually. Kids volley is for us the best ball games for children. And for us, kids volley and the philosophy behind kids volley is the key to success. And it's also, we see it as a key to success in the schools. During the practical demonstration, I will show you what we will do. For we actually do four against four. We do it with a big success because we are looking into the schools and see how can we do something in the schools where we can have 40, 50 children in a sports hall, in a little place. So we use four against four games. But it also, as Remco told, it's based on catch and throw motions for the smallest children. And then it's built up with more and more techniques coming on. Our level one is four against four and only catch and throw motions. Level two, you put in underhand pass, and we also do the smash over the net. So we have learned it from circulation volleyball from Adrien Nooy from Holland in the beginning of 2000, I think, and we have built our own system about how we do four against four. But that is our key to success, and we think that is something who works very well. Kids volley, four against four, is a starting game for the smallest children, and a game where everybody can have success for the first time. And I think we have Remco and Christoph, they showed a lot from the clubs. I think they were tremendous good boys. They were playing very well. But when I come into the schools, I have so different kinds of boys and girls. I have boys who can't throw a ball. I have boys were falling over their own feet. And so it's very, very important that we have a game to come into the schools where they can have success and the teachers feel that works, they can do it. And I think that the kids volley level 1, catch and throw, and when you go to level 2, where you have more volleyball techniques, it works actually. As the two gentlemen also tell, we have the possibility to differentiate. And I think in schools, when you are a teacher at school, it's very important that you can have children playing on different levels. I think that's very important. So when we are in a club and we are going to the schools, use your head to think of what can actually function very well to have success. This is a little slide about how volleyball also can be. And I must say in Denmark and also in the Faroe Islands, we see a lot of this. Let me explain. They are playing 6 against 6. We can see it in Danish schools. They say, no, volleyball, no, we don't play volleyball at school. Yes, we start when we are 16, 14 years old, then we are playing. And you know, the volleyball is, yeah, they are 6 against 6. So 95% of school who are doing volleyball in Denmark, they're actually playing 6 against 6. That's not good. When everybody knows that that we all like to see a lot of movements, we all like to see a lot of smash, and we like to see flow in the game, then you can see 82% was zero contacts. That means the ball was serving to the nets, it was serving out of the court, or when it come over the net, yeah, nobody touched it. So the only exercise the children get was to move in one place and wait until the next ball go into the net. So we have a problem. We have a problem indeed. So it is very important that we use games who have a lot of movements, a lot of flow in the game, and you can choose if you will do it 1 against 1, 2 against 2, but in Faroe Islands and in Denmark we prefer 4 against 4 because it works in the schools, because it's easy. As a club and as a federation, we like to have that we have that when we have been into a school and introduced kids volley, then the children start in our club. That's a goal, to get as lot of children coming into our club when we have been in the schools. Our experience is that to get a link between club and schools and get a better and more effective recruitment is important. And the way that we are doing it is when you are going into the schools, then do it properly and do your best. I've seen a lot of clubs going into school and say, oh yes, we are doing this and this volleyball and it functioned, but they don't have any materials. Where do we start? When do we train? What does it cost? So that is not to do it the best. To have a project about schools, of course, that's very, very important in recruitment, because in the schools you have the whole target group. So when you go to the schools, you talk to every child in that age. So of course, volleyball at school is very important. One thing we have learned, that when we will communicate with children when they are 8, 10 years old, they don't decide anything. They don't decide if they will go to football, hockey, volleyball, or everything. Who decides at home? In Denmark, it's the mother. It's the mother for sure. So we have made a strategy that we will talk to the mother, because she is the one who decides. So, can we tell the good story about kids wanting, and can we tell the mother that we are taking good care of a child? Then we have a good chance that the children will start to volleyball with us. So, in front of you I have put a magazine. That's a magazine we are giving to all children who are participating in our school project. So the magazine are telling the story of explaining the importance of being active in a young age and pointing out the benefits of kids volley. You have there's also two posters. It's a rose for the mother, and it says, "Can I borrow your child?" And on the other side, there will be when they are training and so on, and all information for the club. And we have also put in for the mother this. Dare you to let your child be at home. So a little bit provoking, but I think that is we are talking to the mother. When we are at the schools, it's also very important for us that the children can bring something at home. So they had something to come home to the mother. Oh, mother, see what I have got here. And they had a barklet, and I think, Thomas, will you explain the barklet? What's in it?
The wristband. Yeah, well, the Danish for this one is den sjoveste sveder, which means sveder is the same word you would use for a child in school who's misbehaved. They come into detention. Some schools, anyway. And the Danish word for detention is sveder. Sjov is fun. So the whole thing says this is the funniest way to be in detention.
Maybe not a catchphrase for the children, but for the parents, they laugh and think that this is very interesting. We also have this tattoos. The tattoos they can put on. I always when I put it here, it's a good thing. But I think it's very nice that we can give something to the children. They can come home and have a talk with their parents about what they have seen in the schools. So just put it on, so it was nice to have a tattoo on the arm. So, when we have made a big effort to get the children into the club, it's very important that we make sure that we get a good experience, that they get a good experience with us. So, as a club, we need to make two very important things. High quality volleyball training. If we can do that, I think the children will stay. But most of all, I think the parents are looking what we are doing. And the parents are saying, oh, he's good. That's good training. And then they will let that child stay to volleyball, because there are competition between a lot of other sports. So high quality volleyball training. But also a good sports environment for children is very important. So I have six bullets that we are working with, and all clubs who are taking part of a school volleyball project, they have to take care of these things. And it's cooperation with parents, children's policy, organization, high level of activity, the good adult, and the physical environment. I think this six bullets is very important that you as a club are thinking about when you will have your children to stay at volleyball at your club. let us see it in a teacher's perspective. I know there's a lot of teachers here, and maybe a lot of your teachers isn't experts in volleyball, in children's volleyball. So why should you join in a volleyball at school project? So let's see. I think that first of all, you can, during a volleyball at school project, you can have it as a course for the teachers. Normally, there's not so many courses where you can learn a lot of things, but this volleyball at school project, I think that's a good opportunity to learn a little bit more. And kids volley, it has a perfect pedagogical structure, and it's perfect for the schools, we think. It's easy to organize. You can have a lot of children on a little space. All students can participate, and everybody can be a success. So there's a lot of things that do that this, for the teachers, is a good project to be in. Now, let's see what we are exactly are doing in the Faroe Islands with this project. When we have to sell a project, it was important for us to go directly to the person who decides. When we have to recruit, we go to the mother, but when we are going to buy, like going to sell this project, we have to go to the one who decides in the schools. So we went to the headmaster. We visit all headmasters on the Faroe Islands and ask them, do you want to join in to this project? And we have, we could offer a 4 days of kids volley introduction for the second and third grade. So we would come to the school 4 times. We could come with balls from CEV and with nets. And what was also was mandatory, that was that they should participate in a school tournament. They got teaching materials and kids volley lessons and plans and periodic plans, suggestions for the teachers. So that what was offered the schools. And out of, in a total of 28 schools, the 25 schools said, oh, we must be in that project. And there's 3 who are not in. That's because it's 3 schools who are on very small islands where only 5 children are, so that don't make any sense to do it there. Let me tell a little bit about the mandatory school tournaments. The school tournaments are a very important part of our work with the schools. School tournaments is finishing the teaching program and all schools looking forward to participate. So we have been on a school 4 times. We have learned children to play kids volley level 1, kids volley level 2. And then they are going to these tournaments with local schools and local classes. In a tournament that can be from 100 or up to 250 children, and they are doing these tournaments. And from the Faroe Islands, we have done 10 of these tournaments, and the winners from the tournaments go to a final in Tórshavn, where the champions of the school tournaments are. And that's a very big thing with a big trophy and medals and everything. But let me just explain a little bit about the principles for these tournaments. Everyone from the class are participating, so you don't picking up children to, oh, you are the best, you can join in. No, everybody are participating. And everybody are participating and collecting points for the class. So a class can, for example, have 6-5 teams, and but they are collecting points for the whole class. So if we have a lot of winners, and the tournaments are held from 9 to 12, And the kids, it's the clubs who are arranging the tournaments and the federation are taking care of communication with the clubs. So school tournaments are very basic for our work on the Faroe Islands, and we have seen such a tournament, and I think it's going great. So that was a little presentation of more, not what we are, what we exactly are doing as a club, going into the schools. So when we are going to a practical session, I'll show you what we do in the schools when we are coming there. Thank you, that was all for me.
Any questions? Peter, oh yeah. So we'll miss you out before we go on now.
Hi, I'm Zoe from Scotland. I'm just wondering about your school tournament. Is it run 4v4? Is that what you... Are your school tournaments run 4v4?
Yes, we are doing school tournaments 4x4. So that's a principle. So we are learning the game 4 against 4, catch and throw, and it's a game that we are doing in the school tournaments. So in a sports hall, we are playing that on badminton fields in Denmark, and in I think maybe in most halls we have badminton fields, so that's very easy to organize.
Thank you.
Sorry, you mentioned near the beginning that there's five.
Where are you from? Main
so Ireland. Sorry, Jeff from Northern Ireland. I'm just wondering if you could break down a little bit the five different levels for yours, just briefly.
I will do it. But it's nearly what Remco said. But let's try. We have divided the kids' volley into six levels. Level 0 to level 5. But what's interesting in the schools is from level 1. Level 1, we have 4 against 4, and it starts with the first technique we are learning, the children, is a serve. So they are starting serving the ball over the net. When the ball is coming over, they catch the ball and throw it back. But when you catch the ball over the net, you have to rotate one place. So you rotate from one place to another, the team are changing place. So when you're doing a mistake, you are going outside the field. But you come into the field again when your team has catch the ball 3 times. Okay? Then you go to the next level, that's level 2. Then we put underarm pass into the game. So we are training underarm pass. But it's the same, still the same principle that we serve, the ball go over the nets, catch the ball back again, but we are catching in the special way, as Remco also told, like this, or like this. Okay? You can come into the field when you have made a mistake, you can come into a field again, caught again, when you do a underarm pass to one of your teammates, then you come into the field again. But level 2, you also have the possibility to smash the ball over net, catch the ball, catch up, and smash over the net. So that's the level 1 and 2 that we are using in the schools from the 2nd to the 4th grade. Okay?
All right. I've got one of these questions that can either be answered yes or no, or you can have an answer which takes about half an hour. I wonder what you prefer. Well, the question is simply, you had 25 out of 28 schools.
Yeah.
How easy was it in the Faroe Islands to convince teachers that volleyball is so much better than, for instance, handball or football? How easy was it to convince them and the headmasters that take in volleyball because this is the best sport in the world?
I think when you come to the headmaster and show him a program and tell him that we will bring something new to his school and bring something new to his teacher, and they actually don't know anything about it, they are very curious, and the teachers are taking so good against kids' volley. So So I think it has been very easy to convince the headmasters to go into that project. So we have no problems by that.
And just one last recommendation to Peter before having a break is that you use the Dutch model on the three schools with only five kids, because they've got two and so on, so they can even be active, but you have to wear my raincoat to the Faroe Islands. then everybody plays volleyball up there, which is the definition of success. Okay, good. We're going to take a break, 10 minutes this time, so 5:30, meeting back, and on for Marco after that. All right, Peter, thank you very much indeed. That was excellent.